live for. We look for a family reunion or some kind of old kind of gathering so we can just let our hair down and forget about who we are. I heard Sister Johnson say that she was letting her hair down one time down there in one of them casinos and ran upon some more folks from the church letting their hair down. Amen.
That's right.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. We got to be careful where we are. We don't get no time off. What God does is blesses us for our strength.
Thank you, Lord.
He counsels us to stay in the strength of God so that, and it's not if the enemy is coming, it's when he comes.
Come on.
Amen. Yes. Amen. When you read, I think it's in Ephesians, when he says, put on the whole armor of God, that you'll be able to stand in the evil day. Didn't say nothing about if they come. He says they are coming. And you got to be prepared for the evil one. Because he's always on the prowl. I hear somebody say he's like a roaring lion running to and fro, seeing who he may devour. And if you take a day off from your Christianity, if you put the strength and power of a risen Savior down for a minute, he's right there because he's looking for him. And most of us give him a way in. Amen. And then act like we don't know how he got there. It's like inviting somebody to spend the night and waking up that morning wondering what they're doing in your house. Amen. But he counseled them to keep their strength. And he counseled them to keep God Christ's word. Amen. You can't keep something that you don't have.
All right.
Amen. You can't keep something that you don't have. I know I gotta read some over and over again and say it sometime and live it and do it sometime before it becomes part of me. And God's word is the same way. You can't just read it, you know, go on and read you some bedtime scripture. Amen.
All right, now.
Amen. I used to try to read before I went to bed. Never did make it through nothing.
No, that's right.
Because the eyes get real weary, don't they?
Yes.
Amen. When you read your scripture, you ought to read it at your freshest point.
Amen.
Whatever that is. I'm not going to say mine first thing in the morning because it ain't. Because I can wake up and go back to sleep real fast. Amen. But I got to wait till I moved around a while and got everything woke up. Amen. And no matter how long I slept, I got to give myself some time to adjust so God can speak to me.
Yes.
And you can't expect God to speak to you in the midst of all your stuff.
Amen.
Y'all hear me?
Yes.
All that stuff you do, then you want to take a 15-minute break and let God talk.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You gotta be prepared for God's word to speak to you. He counseled them to keep Christ's word, and he also counseled them to keep Christ's name, to live by the name of Christ.
Amen.
God called you a Christian. You need to live like a Christian. You need to think like a Christian. You need to act like a Christian. The faithful church, although we stumble. We realize our stumbles and we get up.
Amen.
Amen. And we repent of that and we don't go around doing the things that the world do and calling ourselves Christians.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
And then he also counseled them to overcome. Mm-hmm. In verse 12. He said, we need to overcome opposition, tax on our witness, and to listen to the Spirit. Verse 13. Opposition. Where's opposition come from? Where's opposition come from? It comes from within. Amen. Most of our opposition comes from those we know the most.
Amen.
Those we're the closest to. Most of us are in a war among ourselves all the time. But if you're a Christian, God is trying to lead you to doing the right thing.
Amen.
But that other fellow. Amen.
Yes.
I'm not going to call him Satan. I'm going to call him me. The other fellow wants to do what he wants to do.
All right. Come on.
Amen. So you're always in a war. But you need to stand fast. And when the opposition comes, we need to not let it overtake us. Amen.
That's
And we need to overcome him. We need to overcome the attacks on our witness.
Yes.
Amen. Do you witness? If you don't ever witness, then you don't have to worry about
no attack.
Right,
come on.
Amen. But you got to be witness for Christ.
Amen.
If Christ has done something for you, you got to witness for him.
Amen.
Now, when you witness, folk going to attack you for your witness.
All right, come on.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Because they don't know what's on the inside of you.
Amen.
They know what they want to see.
Amen.
And a lot of times they ain't seeing what they see. They see what they saw a long time ago.
Amen.
We get attacked for what we used to be.
All right.
Amen. Folks don't even know who you are no more.
Amen.
They only know you by your street name.
Amen.
You know. Amen. But God has changed you from the inside.
Yes.
And we have to overcome those attacks that folks throw at us. Amen. Amen. And I'm not just talking about the folks that walk in the street. I'm talking about the folks that's in the church.
Amen.
Amen. Do you know there's a lot of jealousy in the church?
Amen.
Amen. Because you stand up and witness for the Lord, because you stand up and tell the world that God has saved you. There are folk who ain't got the nerves to do that.
Yes.
And they're jealous that you do.
Yes.
And they will attack every word you say.
All right.
Let me tell you, I wasn't had no intention of doing no preaching, because I know you scrutinized.
All right, as soon as
I got my little preaching thing, the deacon was trying to figure out if I knew anything. And I just got them things. But God provides to those who trust him. Amen. And the last thing that the writer did was told the church, don't forget God's promises. Amen. Amen. God has promised us that he would keep us, amen, from the hour of temptation in verse 10.
Yes.
He's going to keep us from all temptation that comes our way. He's going to give us the strength to overcome temptation.
Yes,
amen.
Yes,
amen. Y'all don't know about no temptation. Amen. Because temptation is on every hand. Especially when ain't nobody present but you.
Say that now.
Ain't that right?
Yes.
How quick
yes.
do we forget that God ain't here? However, we got quick that he's not everywhere. We forget that he don't know. He is. So you do your little dirt. What the Bible said, that those things you done in the dark
come to the light.
In the light.
Yeah.
So the writer says, God will keep us from an hour of temptation. That's a promise.
Yes, it is.
You got to trust him that he's going to take care of